सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. So before entering into today's satsang, I wanted to remind all of you, these satsangs are specially for creating an effect on people. So I wanted all of you to sit in Padmasana and Samana Mudra. I can see already the yen effect has started happening on the globe. Today's subject is become invisible, unknowable. Patanjali is expanding on the next level of samyama, a next powerful technique. Yetena sabdadi antardana muktam. Vivekananda translates this sutra as, in this manner the disappearance or concealment of words which are being spoken and such other things are also explained. Swami Prabhavananda translates this sutra as, thus also its sounds cease to be heard. Swami Sachidananda translates this sutra as, in the same way, the disappearance of sound, touch, taste, smell is explained. Osho says, this principle also explains the disappearance of sound. This sutra explains the technique of disappearance of sound also. The yesterday sutra was giving us the samyama technique for disappearance of seen. If you practice that samyama, how you can disappear invisible from others' eyes, or how you can realize what you are seeing is not reality. In the sutra, Patanjali explains a method or process for same way making you inaudible. For example, if you apply the same principle of samyama which you understood yesterday in last sutra, for the ears, you can stop hearing others, or you can make others stop hearing you. You may be talking, but you will, the only whom you want will be listening you, not others. If you want a particular person should not hear you, he will not be able to hear you. You can separate. What's the technique? When you create a sound, to samyama on how sound happens, and do samyama on the ears of a person who is receiving the sound, on whose ears the sound is becoming meaningful words. Once you do samyama on the person who is hearing, on his ears, and give a command, let it be separated, You will be talking or shouting, doing what you want. The person will not be able to listen, hear. He will not be able to understand what is being taught or what is being told. These are some of the extraordinary powers. The same way, smell can be separated. Touch can be separated. Somebody can touch you, but you will not feel the touch. You can touch somebody and they will not feel your touch. It's almost like a mastery over the sensory realities. Mastery over the sensory realities makes you understand the sensory realities are not realities. Only when you master something, you will understand the whole, complete. All the great miracles, extraordinary powers, expressions you read, study in different masters' lives, enlightened beings' lives, is all these great yogic powers. It is these great yogic siddhis. It is this yogic siddhis which are responsible for creating those miracles. I can say all yogis, all siddhas were not only expressing the extraordinary powers, they also realized the ordinary reality is not reality. Ordinary reality is not reality. Try it on yourself. Do samyama on how the sounds are heard and converted into meaningful words. How the touch is felt, converted into experience of pain or pleasure. How the smell is felt, converted into good or bad. Do samyama on the spot where the conversion happens. Work on the space where the meaning is added to what is. Then you will be very easily able to separate. Actually, you can try this experiment. Take a candy and a green chili, put both on your tongue in two ends. One side touch your tongue with the candy, very sweet candy. Other side with the green chili. Be aware of both. What is happening? How the tongue is responding? Do samyama on it. Suddenly you will realize both excitement is one and the same. It is you who is labeling it. This is hot, this is sweet. This samyama will liberate you, will make you realize experience will make you understand how to do samyama on the sound, how to do samyama on the touch, how to do samyama on the scene. Doing samyama on all these five, exactly on the spot, on the space where the cognition happens, where the recognition happens, will lead you to have extraordinary powers and the realization reality is not the ultimate reality. Suddenly now I am feeling the morning sutras of Patanjali and evening sutras of Vyasa, both are overlapping on each other, or both are complementing each other. Patanjali prepares you for Vyasa. Vyasa again raises you to Patanjali. Morning sutra is more like a knowledge with technique. By the time you practice the technique and either experience or tired, evening Vyasa breaks your head without any technique. Whether you practiced and successful or whether you are tired of practicing, Vyasa breaks your head without technique. So try samyama on where you hear the sound. In Patanjali, you need to do some practice. In Vyasa's Brahma Sutras, the only practice you need to do is after you imbibe, you should express, means nididhyasana, you should talk it out, you should inspire others. Understand? In Vyasa Sutras, Brahma Sutras, if you don't talk to people, if you don't do nididhyasana, expressing in your words, in your actions, if you are not inspiring, then it won't work. You will forget it. The problem is, you will get into the laziness. Tamas. Tamasa. It doesn't get imbibed in you. It doesn't get settled in you. Method in which Patanjali works is working in you. In Brahma Sutras, the method Vyasa works is you should talk it out. Only when you tell others, your own brain, your own dormant parts of the brain which has not understood or become aware or imbibed will suddenly open up and imbibe. Let's get into samyama. Bring your whole awareness to the ears. See how the sounds are heard. Please understand, I am not saying hear. I am saying see. See how the sounds are heard inside your head. How meanings are made for the sounds. Close your eyes. See See how you make meaning for the sounds. Do samyama on that very space where the sounds are heard and meanings are made. Try this samyama today, whole day. We'll gather again in the evening for Brahma Sutras. I bless you all to achieve, experience, live, radiate, express, and share the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
Let's go.